Hey, welcome back to the channel. All right, so a little while ago, I did a video on reasons why to use a Chromebook. It got really good reception. A lot of questions came out of that, and a lot of those questions revolved around gaming. So that's what this video is gonna be about. This is gonna talk about how to game on a Chromebook. Now, I just wanna start this off by saying that if gaming is your primary focus, a Chromebook is not what you wanna get. You're gonna wanna get a gaming machine for that. This is for people that have Chromebooks, they like what they have to offer, and they wanna know how they can do some casual gaming on the go. Now, as usual, I'll have links down in the description to everything I talk about in this video. And with all that out of the way, let's jump right into it. So the first thing I want to talk about is native gaming on Chrome OS. And obviously, these are going to be web-based games. You can go out to the Chrome Store. There's a ton of them out there. These are really lightweight, casual games. They do have stuff like the original Doom got ported. So you can play that in Chrome OS if you want. But most of them are going to be kind of strategy type games, not real high action, but a lot of them are really fun. And I definitely recommend that you go out there and check out what the Chrome Store has to offer. There's a ton of free stuff out there. Next up is Android apps, and pretty much any recent Chromebook is gonna have native support for Android applications. I tried a lot of the games that are in the Google Play Store. Pretty much all of them worked. In fact, I can't think of one that didn't work. Some of them have gamepad support, some of them don't. It's really easy to pair up a gamepad to your Chromebook, especially through Bluetooth, or if your Chromebook has a USB port like mine does, you can just plug a wired controller in there and use that. Even if the game doesn't have gamepad support, you can still use the touchscreen, and most Chromebooks are lightweight enough and small enough that using that touchscreen actually works out really well. This is a really great option because there are some near console quality games in the Google Play Store, so I would recommend that you go out there and try out those games and see what runs well on your machine. Next thing I wanted to talk about is cloud gaming, and this is provided in a few different ways. Now, one of those ways requires you to have a client on your workstation, and in the Google Play Store, there are a bunch of different Android clients that do work on Chromebooks that connect out to different game streaming services. Now, the problem with those is there's a little bit extra latency when you're running those Android apps versus connecting directly to the game server. A lot of them do provide gamepad support, so whether you're using a wired or wireless gamepad, a lot of them support that, but what they don't usually support is mouse and keyboard. So the next option is to find a streaming service that lets you connect through a web browser. Now, Google is coming out with one later in the year. I think it's supposed to be out in November. But until then, I tried a few different ones, and the one that I found that works the best is Vortex. Now, Vortex, you sign up with your account, you can link to your Steam account, and then you can play the games right in a web browser. Nothing needs to be loaded on your machine. The latency is very low. It was actually an enjoyable experience. If you're doing something competitive, you're not gonna wanna do it this way. There is a tiny, tiny bit of latency, but for the average single player game, it works just fine. So for the cloud gaming, there is a few other options. One is an application called Parsec that you can load on your gaming machine, load the client on your Chromebook, and stream your games from your own powerful gaming machine. You can also get gaming VPNs and load Parsec on there and stream through there. That is much more complicated, much more expensive if you go in the gaming VPN route. And if you're gonna end up going that route, then you probably would be better off with a gaming machine. So it's beyond the scope of this video. Next thing I wanted to talk about is something that didn't quite work out, but it's something that's coming in the future, so I still wanted to mention it, and that is running Linux games natively in Chrome OS. Now, most modern Chromebooks and Chrome boxes will have native support for Linux applications, but the problem is that there is no GPU acceleration. Up until recently, there was no sound either. The sound issue has been resolved, but there's still no graphics acceleration. So I even tried loading Steam in there, which worked fine, but then streaming from another machine to my Chromebook, and I couldn't even stream because of the lack of graphics acceleration. Once they get that resolved, you'll be able to do that, and in theory, load Linux games and load the Linux version of Steam on your Chromebook without doing anything extra and stream from another machine. So I'm really looking forward to that. But like I said, it's not quite there yet because of that GPU acceleration. So that's really everything I wanted to talk about on the native side, but there is another way to vastly improve the library of games that are available on your Chromebook, and that is with installing Linux through something called Crouton. Now, I did a full tutorial video. I'll put a link right up here, so I'm not going to talk about how to do this. You can check out that video. It'll walk you through all the steps. But once you get that set up, you can switch over into a Linux environment and load pretty much any Linux game that your hardware will support. And you can also install Steam and install Steam games through there. You can do streaming from your gaming computer through Steam Link if you so choose to do that. It works really well. Again, most Chromebooks don't have a powerful GPU, but this version of Linux does have full sound, full GPU acceleration, etc., etc. It works really well. It's really solid, and you can play a ton of games, especially casual games like RimWorld, Oxygen Night included, things like that. A lot of the strategy games work. If you're going to do really graphical, like, you know, first-person shooters and stuff like that, it's still doable, but you're going to have to set all the settings way low, but that is no different than a lower-powered Windows laptop as well. This works really well. It's a great way to vastly expand the library of games and applications that are available on your Chromebook. So that's all the ways I've personally found how to play games on a Chromebook, but if you know of others, please leave those down in the comment section below. Also, if you have any questions on anything I talked about, leave that in the comment section below too. I try to answer as many comments as I can. Hopefully you found this useful and informative. If you did, hit that thumbs up. If you really liked it and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so, and I will see you in the next video.